Alaska Garden. I'm with University of Alaska Fairbanks Cooperative Extension Service and Tanana Chiefs Conference. Today I'm at Terry Reichardt's greenhouse. Terry's an amazing gardener. She, in addition to hunting and fishing, she grows about 95% of her family's food each year and stores it in a root cellar and has tricks to extending the season as well. So one of them is this attached greenhouse. It's attached here on the south side of her home. And she's able to put plants in the greenhouse. You're able to do that in as early as February?
I can't keep them in the greenhouse all night long. Mm-hmm. But on sunny days, and in February, we have lots of sunny days. Usually, whatever's usual in Alaska, I'll put them out here. And then I don't have to use much grow light.
And then she keeps her tomatoes in the greenhouse, and they usually survive into November. So for Alaskans, that's a really long season for a greenhouse. And you're really not adding much fossil fuel or using much fossil fuel heat at all. She heats with wood heat, and because it's attached, you can just open the door.
Yeah.
And another trick you use to retain the heat is using insulation panels on the outer part of the greenhouse. And you've also got an insulated floor as well as an insulated panel on top. So when it's coldest, you just have a few of the panels exposed to the cold air.
Yeah, so I'll put styrofoam, those foam boards, around the outside and hold them up. And then just have a little bit of the glass that where the sun shines right in on the plants. Usually in the spring when I'm starting seeds, the plants are small, so they're up on shelves. And I don't need any of the bottom part to get sun. So that's all enclosed with insulation.
And then you've also got your containers are covered in tin foil. And why do you do that?
When they're inside with no air circulation, really, the black pots, most of them are all black, will absorb too much heat and they'll burn the roots, especially if they're pretty close to the window. So you need to reflect the light off of that. That wouldn't be true outside where you have decent air circulation.
And then in addition to, you know, making sure your greenhouse is hot enough, you also need to make sure it's cool enough. So how do you make sure your greenhouse stays cool enough?
Well, we have a fan in the wall at one end, and then I hang a fan at the other end. Theoretically, you should only need one sucking it out, but it seems that we can move the air a lot faster if we have one blowing in from out there. That was a mistake I made. I should have, and we're going to try to do it, had a fan in the roof there that would blow it out. Even just having an opening in the roof without a fan would let all that hot air go up and out, and it would be a lot easier to keep the greenhouse cooler, which is the biggest challenge when the sun shines.
Yeah. So let's take a look inside.
Okay. Our grandson plays the keyboard.
So, what kind of, can you talk a little bit about which varieties of tomatoes you found work for your greenhouse here?
Some of my favorites, one called Silvery Fir is, I'm getting tomatoes off of that in June, and that's usually very early. I really like that. Oh, I pick varieties, as you can see, that are fairly short because my greenhouse has a limited size and I really can only do one row of plants. So things get crowded and I have to think about plants that produce a lot of tomatoes without a lot of size. Two varieties I do are what we call storage tomatoes. And they are indeterminate tomatoes. All the others are determinant, or bush varieties. But the determinants produce storage tomatoes that will store. We store them as till we eat them all up, which is usually somewhere around the end of February. And they store wonderfully. And I would say even in February, they taste better than supermarket tomatoes.
And that was the indeterminate
variety. The two storage varieties. One is called Long Keeper, and the other is called, what is this?
Treasure?
Oh, yes, Golden Treasure.
And that okay. These are the two indeterminate.
Those are two storage tomatoes that are indeterminate.
And the rest are
And that's a pain in a greenhouse this size because they grow so, I mean, they never stop growing. And so I try to have them grow on ropes that I can keep bending around and...
And do you top them when you get to the end of your season?
In November or something like that, I'll top them off. But I've got to keep growing them in a circle so that they don't grow out the glass.
Yeah.
And then I like this orange tomato. It's called Sweet Tangerine. And that lovely orange color makes salads look really fruity or whatever you put it in. Red Rocket is an old variety that is always good, pretty early. And Season Starter is very early, nice big juicy tomatoes. And I guess that's most of the different varieties that I have.
So a couple other questions. Do you pinch the suckers on your tomatoes, and then do you come in here and shake them to pollinate them a little bit? Or
that's if you do that once a day, you'll have plenty. I don't always remember to do that. You don't generally take suckers off of, and I have done it for other reasons, off of your determinant tomatoes. I'll cut them instead if, but... your indeterminate tomatoes, you need to keep the suckers off of. And keep them down. You can choose to do one vine or two vines. I wouldn't do more than two vines and keep it going.
Great. Yeah. And when do you start your tomatoes usually?
Inside? I start them February 1st.
Okay.
And then we're eating by June 1st. We're eating tomatoes because, I mean, why not? I start on my... transfer them into these pots, and then I can put them in the greenhouse and keep them there, so I'm not hauling them in and out.
So that's really an advantage of an attached greenhouse. If you have a detached greenhouse, it's going to be a lot more expensive to heat. You know, if you are able to attach it to your house on the south side, you've got the light, and then you've got one really well insulated wall, and if you're heating with wood heat, or you have another good way to heat your home, you just open up the door and you can easily transfer things inside and outside.
And you can even, if you have a south window, you can even put a little plastic covered box. When I first built this, before I put glass on, I just had a nice plastic on it. And that, you know, worked pretty well. The glass is nicer.
Yeah.
But yeah, there are all kinds of ways you can take advantage of a house in the south side.
And a greenhouse. Yeah. Well, great. Thanks, Terry. I'm Heidi Rader here in the Alaska Garden. Thanks for listening.